गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन. इन टुडे सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस बोनस शेयर एंड स्टॉक स्प्लिट. व्हाट इज अ बोनस शेयर एंड व्हाट इज अ स्टॉक स्प्लिट. व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द टू एंड हाउ दे आर यूज्ड बाय द कंपनीज टू यू नो इंक्रीज द कैपिटल टू मेक द शेयर होल्डर्स हैप्पी विद द सेम अमाउंट ऑफ कैपिटल. सो लेट्स सी. बोनस शेयर्स इन्वॉल्व्स पेमेंट टू द एग्जिस्टिंग ओनर्स ऑफ डिविडेंड in the form of shares. So here, instead of giving cash dividend, we are giving a share as dividend. So what happens in that case is the firm can save its cash. If I don't want to spend my cash, I need it for certain purpose, but I want to give dividend, then and I will call it as bonus share. So suppose each share is of 10 rupees, I will give one share as bonus for you instead of giving you 10 rupees dividend. Now, how are these bonus shares basically given? The bonus shares are given on a pro rata basis to the current shareholders. What is pro rata basis? Pro rata basis is nothing but how much you're already holding. On the basis of that, I will give you additional bonus shares. So a particular ratio is decided by the firm as to how much bonus shares will be given. So let us take an example and understand it. Suppose the bonus share ratio decided by the firm is 1:10. Okay, so 1:10 ratio for bonus share. Okay, so what is 1:10 ratio? That means if you have 10 shares, I will give you one share as bonus. So it is, I'll write it here, for every 10 shares you hold, you get one share as bonus. So suppose I hold 100 shares. So for 100 shares, how many bonus shares I'll get? For every 10 shares, one. So for 100, how much? So I will get 10 shares. So I'll get 10 bonus shares. You can calculate for one share, I will get, for 10 shares, I will get one share as bonus. So for 100 shares, how much? So I'll do 100 into 1 divide by 10, that comes to 10 bonus shares. So once the ratio is decided, depending on that, you will get the bonus shares on pro rata basis. Pro rata is how much you hold. If I hold 100 shares, I'll get 10 bonus shares. If I hold only 10 shares, I'll get one bonus share. So for every 10 shares you hold, one bonus share is what the company will give you for free. So you need not pay for those, that one share which you're going to get, or these 10 shares, because this is kind of a dividend. Instead of giving you cash dividend, the company is giving you bonus share as dividend. Okay, so that was about bonus shares. Let's understand what is stock split. Stock split is a method commonly used to lower the market price of the shares by increasing the number of shares belonging to each shareholder. Now here we are not giving any shares on bonus, but we are trying to reduce the market price of the share by increasing the number of shares. Now why does company go for stock split and what does it get by doing all this? Okay, so we'll understand it. An integral part of dividend policy of a firm is use of bonus share and stock split. So usually in dividend policy or while paying dividend, they usually use bonus share or stock split. Okay, both involve issuing new shares on pro rata basis. So we'll understand what is stock split in detail. When the firm's asset, while the firm's assets, its earning, the risk being assumed, and the investor percentage remains unchanged. So here, by giving bonus shares or by doing stock split, your position in the company will remain unchanged. You're getting bonus shares, but only you're not getting it. Everybody else is getting it. So all will have the same position. Same way it is with the stock split. The only definite result from either a bonus share or stock split is the increase in the number of shares. So if I give bonus shares, my number of shares will increase, or if I do stock split, I split one share into 10, my number of shares will increase. In the equity portion of the firm, a bonus issue reduces the retained earnings. Now, how does a bonus share given to you will show in the balance sheet? So it will reduce the retained earnings and it will increase the equity capital, and correspondingly increasing the paid up equity and share premium, if any, whereas stock share or whereas share split or stock split has no such effect. So first let's understand the effect of bonus share. So how it will look on the balance sheet? Now, as you know, the balance sheet has two parts, the assets and the liabilities. So it will have an impact on the liability side only. Let me explain you here. So these are the liabilities. Okay, so suppose here the company has a share capital. Write the amount here. Share capital of 10 lakhs. And it has retained earnings. Of 5 lakhs. Okay, now the company has announced this is the position before bonus. Okay. Now suppose the company has announced bonus issue. Let me just copy to the next slide so that I can show you before after on the same thing. Continue here only. Suppose this is a position before bonus issue. So share capital 10 lakh, retained earnings 5 lakh. What will happen after bonus issue? We will see. So if I decide, the company decides. Suppose the company decides to give 1000 bonus shares of rupees 10 each. Now remember, bonus shares are given as dividend, so company will not get money. It will give shares for 10 rupees each for free. So 1000 shares into 10 rupees if I do, how much amount? Or we'll say the company gives 10,000 shares of, let's take it as 10,000 shares of 10 each. So the amount will be equal to 1 lakh rupees. Now this 1 lakh rupee shares are gone into the market, but company has not received the money from it still. So what are we going to do, or what are we supposed to do with this 1 lakh rupee? How are we supposed to show it in our balance sheet or in our liabilities? Now the share capital should increase by 1 lakh rupee, but the company has not received, here I'll write after bonus issue. The company has not received any money. These shares are given for free. 10,000 shares of 10 each are given as dividend to the shareholders. But in my share capital, I'll have to show this 1 lakh rupees, because shares of 1 lakh rupees have gone into the market. So what I will do is I'll make my share capital as 11 lakh, because the number of shares increased and the capital increased by 1 lakh. Now this 1 lakh came from where? It came from reduce my retained earnings to 4 lakh. So here if you see, before issue 10 lakh was capital, 5 lakh was retained earnings. After bonus issue, capital became 11 lakh and 1 lakh from retained earnings is transferred to capital, because these retained earnings are earnings of the owners itself, the shareholders. So instead of giving them cash earnings, I increase their share capital. So from the reserves, I take 1 lakh, which is theirs, and add it to the share capital. Still, my balance sheet will be 15 lakh total here and plus 15 lakh total here. So the effect on the balance sheet will be same. But instead of having 10 lakh capital, 5 lakh earnings, now I have 11 lakh capital and 4 lakh earnings. So this is how bonus share will impact the balance sheet. But stock split will not do anything such. So stock split is totally a different phenomena. Let's understand now what happens when it comes to stock split. So here you can see it is told stock or share split has no such effect. Whereas bonus share, if you see, I told you, in the equity portion of the firm, a bonus issue reduces the retained earnings and correspondingly increases the paid up capital. So in the example I showed you, retained earnings reduced by 1 lakh and share capital increased by 1 lakh. So let's see now what is the advantage of stock split. Okay, the issue of bonus share or stock split would have the effect of bringing the market price of the shares within more popular range as a result of large number of shares outstanding. So usually when we give bonus share or we do stock split, the market price of the share comes down because we issue additional shares, the number of shares increases and the price comes down. Now let's understand stock split with an example, because till now we're discussing only bonus shares in detail. So first thing, what is stock split? Stock split is nothing but when you split your share. Okay, so you divide your share. So the stock split ratio may be, maybe I say 1:10, or let's say 1:5. Let's take the example little different. 1:5 rate or ratio, I'm going to do stock split. That basically means if you have one share of ABC company, you will have to surrender that one share to the company and get 5 new shares from the company . Now here I have not put the amount. I'm just trying to explain you how the stock split happens. Okay, so if you have one share, it will be split into 5. So that means you will have to go and give that one share to the company. Instead of that, the company will give you 5 shares. Now let's understand. If you have one share of ABC company, if you have one share of rupees 50 of ABC company, then you will have to surrender that one share to the company and get 5 shares of rupees 10 each from the company. So if you see, 1 into 50 is 50, and 5 into 10 is also 50. So the amount won't change. You will get 5 new shares of the same amount. Still your capital is 50 rupees only. But instead of one share of 50 rupees, now you have 5 shares of 10 rupees. So you still have 50, but the number of shares have increased. Now why will company do such thing? It will do these things to reduce its share prices. What is the advantage that the company gets for reducing its share prices? Sometimes the share prices reach to such a height that it becomes difficult for people to trade. Like suppose a company share price is 10,000, 12,000. Only rich and high net worth investors will be able to afford to buy them. But the salaried class or the middle income or upper income class people will not afford to buy those company shares. Then what happens is the trading becomes slow. People won't buy that company shares because the share is too costly and they cannot afford it. So the company does stock split. So now instead of buying one share for 50 rupees, you can buy 5 shares of 10 rupees. Or maybe I'll say, instead of the share price being 50 rupees, now it has become 10 rupees. So it becomes affordable for many people to buy, and buying and selling increases. Nothing will happen to the company's balance sheet. Capital will be the same. Only thing is, instead of one share, I'm splitting it into 5. So the ratio can differ. I have taken 1:5 ratio. It can be 1:10, 1:2 also. You give one share and get 2 shares. Depending on by how much the company wants to reduce its share price, it is decided. So companies whose share prices are growing at a very fast rate and their market price are going to grow again further, they usually go, they will split, get the price down, again work hard, the prices will go on increasing. So now if the price increases, you will have 5 shares. Suppose the price becomes 12 rupees. So 5 into 12, 60 rupees you will get. So, and plus it becomes easy because an investor can sell part of its shares also. If I want to sell only 2 shares from 5, I can sell 2 and keep 3 with me. But in the previous case, I had one share of 50 rupees. I want only 20 rupees. I cannot share half the share or 0.2 of the share. I'll have to sell the full share and get 50, but I wanted only 20. So it was not possible. But in this case, I have 5 shares of 10 each. I can sell only 2 and get 20 rupees. 3 shares can still remain with me of 30 rupees. So it becomes easy for trading. That's why stock split is done. So this was about bonus share and stock split. I hope you've understood it. There may be differences if asked. So difference between a bonus share and stock split is, bonus share is you're issuing additional shares for free. Stock split is you're splitting the existing shares into different into more number of shares. Bonus shares has an impact on the company's balance sheet. It will reduce the retained earnings and increase the share capital. Stock split has no impact on the company's balance sheet. Bonus shares is giving a new share for free, whereas stock split is you're not giving new shares, but you're just splitting the existing shares into different parts. Bonus share is used to give cash dividend, whereas stock split is done to reduce the market price of the share so that trading becomes easy. So these are some of the basic differences between the two. So this was all about bonus share and stock split. I hope you understood it. Thank you.